The Kingdom of Sweden in Northern Europe is sandwiched by Norway in the west and the Baltic Sea and Gulf of Bothnia in the east. Iron ore deposits in the north of the country have long contributed to the country's high standard of living and social security. The North Swedish town of Gamlestad was awarded a place on UNESCO's World Heritage List. Wooden houses around a church served as shelter in the 15th century for those members of the congregation who either lived too far away to return home the same day or who were otherwise blocked by the often adverse weather. Luleå's first mention in history places it on the very spot of today's Gamlestad. Luleå is about 110 kilometers, 70 miles south of the polar circle in Norrbottens land province, with its shores on the Gulf of Bothnia. The local climate is one of mild summers and harsh winters. Luleå is a major port and regular home to a fleet of impressive icebreakers. Flowing into the Gulf of Bothnia is the Luleå Elvan, the Lule River. North Swedish iron ore is either processed here in local furnaces or shipped to port for export. The iron ore comes from the mines of LKAB, or Luossavaara Kiirunavaara Aktiebolag, founded in 1890. Thousands of tons are daily transported by MTAB to the ports of Luleå and Narvik in Norway. Some of the iron ore is converted in Luleå to iron in the furnaces of SABB. The unloading of ore at the furnace complex is done automatically, allowing the driver time to clean the windows of his locomotive. The steel plant in Luleå also processes raw iron into steel plates. These are then transported by rail to SABB plants in Sweden and Finland for conversion to the final product. An empty ore train returns to Kiruna for its next load. The rail line is shared with, amongst others, passenger trains owned by Connex, that in 2003 took over operations from TAG Kompaniet. Times, the name Connex was changed to Veolia, the name of the French parent company. We now move to the Arctic Circle, which interestingly runs mostly over land. During the well-known midsummer nights around the 21st of June, the sun remains above the horizon for several nights in a row, In return, there is no sun at all for several days in midwinter. Sweden has a railway station directly on the Arctic Circle, aptly enough named Polcirkeln, Swedish for Arctic Circle. One of the trains to pass through Polcirkeln is the Iore, a daily Norwegian freight train linking Oslo and Narvik. The Iore, short for Arctic Rail Express, is a vital freight link to the north of Norway. As the Norwegian rail network does not reach further north than Bodø, the train makes a detour over Swedish soil. The containers make a 27-hour journey by rail to the port of Narvik, which remains free of ice in the winter. We return to Polcirkeln for an empty ore train from Luleå and a local freight train from Narvik. The natural peace and quiet is all but briefly disturbed by the ore train. This reindeer, shedding its winter fur, seems hardly affected at all. Members of the deer family, reindeer have their habitat on the Arctic tundra. The Sámi people keep reindeer herds for fur, meat and milk, and occasionally use them as beast of burden. They are animals that were made famous by that legendary animal Rudolph with his red nose, who of course is employed by Santa Claus. Over time, the little town of Galivari has become one area with Koskulkulu and Malmberget, a small mining village belonging to the Galivari community. Malmberget literally means ore mountain. Iron ore has been mined here since 1741. One particular feature of Malmberget is that it is split in two by an open mine. Buildings sometimes had to make way as mining progressed. The railway arrived here in 1888. Currently, LKAB employs some 1,000 workers in local mining and processing operations. In the summertime, holiday spirit is in the air, and that means travel. Evidently, the weather does not always cooperate. In terms of surface area, the community of Kiruna may well be the largest in Europe. Its 20,000 square kilometers, or 8,000 square miles, is many times larger than Greater London, but the population is just 25,000, and they are probably outnumbered by reindeer. The old Sarma settlement grew into a real town following the discovery of iron ore. Kiruna is the social and cultural center of a large area that is not easy on its inhabitants. Midwinter is a period of prolonged darkness without sunshine and temperatures down to minus 45 degrees centigrade. Midsummer is a period of prolonged daylight without sunset when temperatures may soar to tropical levels. And then there are mosquitoes and midges. A frequent local quote says, 20 billion midges, can't be wrong. Kiruna is the place to be. In the morning, the Stockholm-Narvik overnight train pauses in Kiruna station after a 17-hour run. Kiruna iron ore mine is the largest open mine of its kind in the world. It is operated by LKAB and of vital importance to the local economy. In 1888, a railway line was opened to transport the ore to Luleå in the east and in 1903 to Narvik in Norway in the northwest. Transport is now in the hands of MTAB, a sister company of LKAB. To pull its trains, MTAB makes use of the new 360-ton Iore locomotives and the class DM3 dating from the 1950s and 60s. A new DM3 rolls out of the Kiruna sheds in 1960. The DM class locomotives, later referred to as DM2, were built as dual units in the 1950s. From 1960 onwards, 19 locomotives received a third unit to become the DM3 class. There is a cab at each end. All three units feature two electric motors powering four axles coupled by rods. For years, the DM3 held the title of longest and most powerful electric train in the world, packing 7,200 kilowatts or 9,800 horsepower in 273 tons of rolling hardware and offering a maximum speed of 75 kilometers an hour. An empty rake is taken to the mine's loading terminal by a T-44 class diesel. But it is not just ore that is transported. Against a backdrop of waste from an old mine, a train leaves for Svappavaara with a load of additives. To make ore suitable for further processing, it is baked into pellets. As the ore is too fine to be used directly, it would choke the furnace. The pellet factory in Svappavaara uses additives to create pellets of roughly 1 centimeter diameter. Pelleted ore is dumped into a large pit from where it is taken to the plant in big dump trucks. The unloading is fully automated whilst the train is being marshalled by a class T46 diesel locomotive. The ore wagons are equipped with heavy center couplers doubling as buffers. These couplers are linked with the compressed air lines. Decoupling uses a pull cord. In Kiruna today, ore is mined deep underground. But back in 1947, it was still a daylight operation with the ore excavated in open pits. Huge bucket loaders filled the wagons destined for Narvik. Today, most ore is first processed into pellets. In Kiruna, 273 tons of DM3 stand ready to take a train loaded with 5,400 tons to Narvik. The rolling stock originally belonged to the Swedish state railways, or Statens Järnvägar. During the privatization of the 1990s, the rolling stock was handed over to MTAB. The old brown color of the DM3 made way for the current blue and gray livery during an upgrading in 1990. The 35-meter-long giants, once among the largest electrics in the world, are limited to 75 kilometers an hour and dated by today's standards. So they are gradually being superseded by the heavier and more powerful Iore locomotives. Shortly after departure, the train passes the Kiruna Roundhouse and Workshop Complex. Iron ore transport is a 24-hour business and a very special sight indeed in the low sun around midnight. A TB class loco takes the road in the early evening hours. In the winter, these locomotives are mainly employed in snow clearing, for which duty they will be equipped with snow plows. In the summer, the TBs are mainly found in charge of work trains and ballast trains. This class of heavy diesel-electric locomotives belongs to Baron Ferket, manager of the Swedish rail network. The loud exhaust of these locos is of particular note. The cramped cowl of the engine compartment left no room for silences. In the year 2000, Bombardier in Kassel, Germany, delivered the first of 18 Iore locomotives. The designation stems from the combination of the words iron and ore. Following an extensive testing program, the first unit entered regular service in 2001. Their all-up weight of 360 tons is divided over 2 6-axle units. They are capable of taking over 8,000-ton ore trains without assistance from Kiruna to either Narvik or Luleå under any weather conditions. The name Torenetrask refers to both a station along the ore railway as well as one of the most beautiful lakes in Sweden. The lake ranks 7th in size nationally and forms part of the Abisko National Park in Swedish Lapland. While the service is based on a non-stop schedule, once in a while, an unscheduled stop is unavoidable. It then takes enormous effort to get the thousands of tons back in motion again. Even railways in the far north of Sweden do not escape modernization. This often means closure of small stations, like Stenbacken. Another view of the serene beauty of Lake Tornenetrask, up to 168 meters deep and stretching for 70 kilometers. Trains then pass the small Abisko tourist station, which, as the name implies, performs a significant role in tourism. Abisko tourist station is the starting point for many walking tours through the unspoiled local scenery. The station is currently served by Veolia trains. The Swedish state railway, Statens Järnvägar, were organized in 1856 and for years coexisted with private companies in a manner similar to Switzerland. Through legislation introduced in the 60s, every form of public transport was required to be self-supporting. First, control and management of the rail network was transferred to Banverket in 1988. In 1999, regional and local passenger transport in North Sweden was awarded to TAG Kompaniet AB. The concession for the Stockholm-Boden-Narvik line was awarded in 2003 to the multinational public transport corporation Connex in France. In 2006, Connex assumed the name of its French parent company, Veolia. Even a bike comes along this way. The tourists have left Abisko tourist station as a DM3 passes with empties from Narvik. A notable feature of recognition in this area is the U-shaped Laporten Valley. The name Laporten stands for Gate to Lapland. Björklin station is 406 kilometers away from Luleå and still another 67 to Narvik. The peace and quiet is severely breached by the sound of brakes from ore trains passing each other on single line working. Björkliden is also a crew change point. In a few moments, the Swedish driver of the Iore will be relieved by his Norwegian colleague entering the station with a DM3 pulling empties from Narvik. Rolling stock crosses the border freely, but drivers are still changed. Near Björkliden, we were pleasantly surprised by this historic train. The 105-ton MA828, built by ASEA in 1953, was in charge of 1940 vintage coaches, which remained in regular service until the mid-1960s. The travel party had disembarked from an old mail boat in Narvik and continued their journey in style to Luleå. On the way to Narvik, a DM3 and its heavy load steadily climb the bank to Vasiore, the highest point on the journey. In Vassijore, the DM3 passes an old Nohab diesel belonging to a railway contractor. Empty ore trains on their return to Kiruna. Little has changed since the 1960s. A train runs its final kilometers on Swedish soil as it approaches Riksgränsen, the border station between Sweden and Norway. Connex or Veolia trains change crews here. Oops, almost forgot to hand over my walkie-talkie. Here, the Swedish Malmbanan becomes Norwegian Ofotbanan, the line between Riksgränsen and Narvik harbour. But before descending down to the level of the fjord, we must pass the monument erected in 1928 to commemorate 25 years of Ofotbanan, the beginning of the real mountain crossing. The magnificent scenic run through Norway involves a crossing over an ancient mountain ridge. The 1,580 kilometers from Stockholm to Narvik take about 21 hours by train. Although the line is shared with passenger trains, its main function remains the transport of iron ore. Narvik is Kiruna's only port guaranteed to stay open all year long. From Narvik, the ore is shipped in huge bulk carriers to points all over the world. The last part of the line proved to be the most difficult to construct and was not opened until 1903. The final 40 kilometers contain stiff gradients, conquering 520 meters of altitude. The Nordals Bridge is the longest in the Norwegian section. Alternative routes without a bridge were perfectly feasible, but the Norwegians chose to build this steel structure, which would be easy to blow up for strategic reasons. The bridge has now been replaced by a tunnel. Hours into its journey, the Stockholm to Narvik night train passes over the new alignment within sight of the old Nordals Bridge. These images convey the beauty of the line, but also serve to demonstrate the challenges faced by the builders during its construction. 169 kilometers from Kiruna, Narvik comes into sight. The train first passes through Narvik station before reaching its final destination at the Iore terminal. Narvik, population about 20,000, is nestled along the deep Ofot fjord. After Russia's Murmansk, it is the most northerly town in Europe connected by rail. The relatively warm Gulf Stream keeps Narvik's harbour free from ice, despite its location at 68 degrees north. This ultimately was the strongest incentive to build the railway through difficult terrain. Luleå's harbour in the Gulf of Bothnia, on the other hand, freezes over in wintertime and requires a lot of effort from heavy icebreakers to keep open. Narvik, too, seems to have changed little in the course of 50 years. The loading of bulk carriers is a continuous 24-hour operation. Hurtigruten is the name of a distinguished shipping company providing transport and ferry services since 1893. The company sails daily from Bergen to Kirkenes in the north. In doing so, Hurtigruten played an important part in the development of the northern regions, which depended on this all-year lifeline, unaffected by snow and ice. Sometimes it looks like traffic congestion, even here. Here, the Lofoten, one of Hurtigruten's older vessels, calls at Narvik Harbour. The giant Iore terminal dominates Narvik. Here, thousands of tons are loaded daily into ships to feed hungry steel furnaces worldwide. This may be the end of a line called Malmbanan, but the world's growing demand for steel suggests there won't be an end to these activities for a long time to come.